double deck over seawall going on. We are replacing this existing deck and installing a new one in this empty lot. Demolition, saw cut this existing concrete slab, graded this area. This side we have demoed all the tile, ready to remove the plywood and the joists so that we can start from scratch. I change shapes just to hide in this place, but I'm still an animal. Nobody knows it but me when I slip. Yeah, I slip, I'm still. Joist at 32 inches on center. In your eyes, I see the eyes of somebody who could be strong. Tell me if I'm wrong. And now I'm pulling your disguise up. Are you free or are you tied up? I change shapes just to hide in this place, but I'm still. Our decking material, we're using a tropical hardwood from Brazil. It's called Ipe. The best way to install tropical hardwood decking is to have a board that is in the end coated on all four sides with oil. We're using Penofin oil. We oil the back side of the board as well as two edges. Then we install the decking, and in the end we oil the top side of the board so that you end up with a deck board that has been oiled on all four sides. Hardwood decking, you basically have three main options. 1x6 measures only 3/4 of an inch thick. 5/4x6 measures exactly 1 inch thick. Main decking profile that I use. 2x6 is true 1.5 inch thickness. I change shapes just to hide in this place, but I'm still. Side we're having a 7-foot tall railing, and on this side our railing is shorter, standard 42 inch height, 4x4 tropical hardwood post, and we're using 1/2 inch tempered glass placed with those stainless steel glass clamps. In your eyes I see the eyes of somebody who could be strong. to be the side yard with grass. And this is the main deck replaced with a new one. There was two gates over here to serve the two gangways. We decided to clean all of that up and create only one gate that goes down to a landing to access both gangway. This is a solid IP gate, 2x4 frame, 5/4x6 balusters. Regular latch here, heavy duty door closer that closes the gate with enough force to latch it, but also at a low speed. We also installed surface bolt here that allows you to lock the gate open if you need to. Big wooden post that holds a 20-foot flagpole. Copper spotlight fixture that shines up on the flag at night. We're having a herringbone board pattern on all the corner transitions. We have this normal active gate over here, but it also allows you to open it all the way, and with this flush bolt over here, have the whole thing swing open. Over here we have a flush mounted floor electrical outlet. All these step risers have small LED riser lights. We have a custom bench. Again, we have the same herringbone pattern at the corner transitions. Then it turns into a bench with a backrest, angled backrest. We gave it some built-in storage. By the front of the house, we built some custom gates. These are also solid IP. On the gates, we have a mechanical key door lock so that nothing can go bad as far as electrical or battery that can run out. Again, you have the door closer here, four heavy duty hinges. We have a little bubble windows for the dogs to peek through the gate. Have little rubber bumpers that absorb the shock of the closure.